KiCad 6 Project Manager, overview of the new version. Hello friends, I want to share my impressions of the new version of KiCad. I, as always, switched to the new version quite late after its release. The 5th version at one time disappointed me a little. At that time, I didn't particularly notice any new features compared to the 4th version, but in the 5th, the normal automatic placement of components on the board disappeared, and, most importantly, the autorouter disappeared. It is clear to me that the autorouter certainly will not completely replace the work of a development engineer, but it was convenient for me to run it for the initial outline of the tracks. And then I manually tweaked about 50% of these tracks. In general, without an autorouter, you feel really lonely. I installed KiCad 6 on top of the 5th version and saw the new design of the project manager. Here the location of the menu and the picture of the icons has changed. Interestingly, the developers have changed the names of the applications. There used to be strange names, but now they are editors. We are now in the KiCad 6 Project Manager window. Here you can create new projects, open and close them. There are also functions for archiving and unzipping projects. If you are familiar with this program for the first time, then I recommend running one of the demo projects through the menu file, Open Demo Project. To help us develop faster, subscribe to the channel, like and share the video link with your friends. Thank you. There are 2 new goodies in the file menu. This means that now you can import a project not only from the Eagle program, but also from CADstar. But the main feature here, which I have been waiting for a long time, is the Save As button. It allows you to completely copy the current project with a new name. The 5th version of KiCad did not have this feature. And, in order to copy the project with a new name, it was necessary to manually copy the project folder in the file system and rename all the files inside separately. Here, as usual, in the project manager with an open project, we see a list of its files. They can be opened from here by double-clicking. The View, Tools, Preferences and Help tabs have not changed significantly. Only the useless Browse tab, which I never used, disappeared here. In addition to files from the Project Editor window, you can run all standard utilities by clicking on their icons. The icons themselves now look more modern in KiCad 6. The Schematic Editor in the previous version was called EE Schema. This is the editor of the electrical circuits of the project. Symbol Editor was called SO in the 5th version. This is an editor of electronic elements or circuit components. It allows you to create and edit custom schematic symbols for schematic elements that are not found in the standard component libraries. Pcb Editor used to be called Pcb New. In it, developers design printed circuit boards and root board tracks. Footprint Editor has not changed its name. This is a Pcb Footprint Editor. In it, you can create and edit user footprints, as well as edit library footprints. Gerber Viewer is a viewer for Gerber files, i.e. files of finished printed circuit boards for their production. Image Converter or Bitmap to Component Converter is used to place logos and pictures on printed circuit boards. Calculator Tools is a set of calculators for developers. The Drawing Sheet Editor is a schematic sheet border editor. Plugin and Content Manager is a utility for connecting plugins and other downloadable packages for the convenience of working with KiCad 6. I don't remember this in the previous version. By the way, plugins can be quite interesting. This concludes my tour of the KiCad 6 Project Manager. So far, we haven't seen any exciting breakthroughs in version 6, but if you liked this review, then I'll take a look at the changes in the main editors further. Maybe there will be something revolutionary. Like this video and subscribe to develop the topic further. I wish you health and longevity.